Welcome to my channel Glory with Mathematics. Please subscribe, like and share.
So let us solve in this section the exercise 1.2 of the chapter Real Number. So first question is, express each number as a product of its prime factor. Some numbers are given, 5 numbers are given. So let us first find the prime factorization of 140. So first one, 140 is equal to. So to find the prime factors, you have to factorize like this. So 140, it is divisible by 2. So 140 is equal to 2 into 70. Again 70 is divisible by 2. So 2 into 35. Then again it is divisible by 5 into 7. So you can write it as 140 is equal to 2 into 2 into 5 into 7. Or that is equal to 2 to the power 2 into 5 into 7. So this is the prime factorization of 140. Again come to second one. 156. The same procedure, 156 is equal to 2 into, this is 78. Again it is divisible by 2, then that is 39. Then this is divisible by 3, 30. So 156 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 13. So this is equal to 2 to the power 2 into 3 into 30. So let us solve the third one, prime factorization of 3825. So 3825, we have to factorize like this. 3825, so this is 3 plus 8, 11, 13. So this is divisible by 3. So you have to check from starting from 2, all the prime factors you have to check. So this is divisible by 3. So this is 1, 3 2 are 6, then 2, 3 7 are 21, then 5. Then again this is 3, 7, so this is divisible by 3. So 3, so this is 4, 3 4 are 12, then 2, then 5. Then this is divisible by 5. 5 into, this is 5 8 are 40, then 5, 5. Then again this is divisible 5, 5, then 7. So 3825 is equal to 3 multiplied with 3 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 5 multiplied with 17. So 3825 is equal to 3 to the power 2 into 5 to the power 2 into 17. So this is the prime factorization of 3825. So let us solve the fourth one. So this is 5005. So here, so 5005, so this is divisible by 5. So this is 5 1, then 0 0 1. Then this is divisible by 11. So 11, 9s are 99, then 1. Then this is also divisible by 7. This is 13. So 5005 is equal to 5 into 11 into 7 into 13. So this is the prime factorization of 5005. Let us find the factors of fifth one, that is 7429. So 7429. So this is divisible by, that is 17. So 17, 4 are 68, then 6 2, 17 3 are 40, 51, then 17 7 are 190. Then it is divisible by 19. So 19, 2 are 38. Then 5, 19, 3 are 27. So 23 is a prime number. So this is equal to 17 into 19, into 23. So this is the prime factorization of 7429. Let us solve question number 2 of exercise 1.2. So the question is, find the LCM and HCF of the following pair of integers and verify that LCM multiplied with HCF is equal to product of two numbers. So let's solve the first one. So first, HCF of 26 and 91. So to find the HCF, we have to write the prime factorization of both the numbers. So 26 is equal to 2 multiplied with 13. And 91 is equal to 7 into 13. So the HCF is equal to the common factor, the lowest power of the common factor. So this is 13. So then HCF is the highest power of the factors. So here 2 to the power 1. So here 2 to the power 0. So 2 into 7 into 13. So LCM is equal to 14 into 13. That is 182. Then you have to verify whether LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers or not. So HCF into LCM is equal to 13 into 182. So this is 2366, and product of two numbers. So you can find the product, that is 2366. So it is verified that HCF into LCM is equal to product of two numbers. Let us solve the second one, that is 510 and 92. So before finding the HCF and LCM, we have to prime factorize these two numbers. So 510 is equal to, we have to factorize here, 510, so this is divisible by 2, 2 to the 4, 2 5, 5. Then this is 3, 385, then 5, then 17. So this is equal to 2 into 3 into 5 into 17. Then come to 92. So 92 can be factorized as 2, 2 4 are 8, 6, then 2, then 23. 23 is a prime number. So this is 2 into 23. So this is equal to 2 to the power 2 into 23. So what is HCF? So here the common factor is 2. So HCF is 2. Then what is LCM? LCM is the product of the highest power of factors. That is 510. This is 2. 2 square. So we will take 2 square. Then 3. Then 5. Then 17. Then 23. So this becomes, so 4 into 3, 12 into 5, that is 60 into 390. So this is equal to 23,460. So what is the HCF into LCM? That is 2 into 23,460 is equal to, then product of two numbers. Is equal to, that is 510 into 92. So that also become, if you find the product, 46,920. So it is verified. Let us solve the third one. So first prime factorization of 336 and 54. So 336 is equal to, so 336 is divisible by 2. So 2 1s are 2 6 8, then 2 84, then 2 42, then 2 21, then 3 7. So this is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 7. So this is equal to 2 to the power 4 into 3 into 7. This is the prime factorization of 336. Again 54. 54 can be factorized 2 into 27, then 3, 9, 3, 3. So this is equal to 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. So this is equal to 2 into 3 to the power 3. So SCF of 336 and 54 is equal to common factor. Here 2 to the power 4 is there. Here 2 to the power 1 is there. So we have to take the lowest power 2. So here 3 to the power 1, 3 to the power 3. So we have to take 3. So SCF is 6. Then what is LCM? LCM is the product of the highest powers of the factors occurring in both the numbers. That is 2, 2 to the power 4 we will take. Then from 3, we will take 3 to the power 3. So then here 7 to the power 1. So this is equal to, this is 16 into 9 into 7. So this is 27. So this is 16 into 3024. So what is SCF into LCM? So this is equal to, so our SCF is 6. 6 into 3024. That is, and product of two numbers is equal to, our two number is 54 multiplied with 336. That also become 18,144. So this is verified.